causal and non-causal systems. What is a causal system? If the output of the system depends on present and past values of the input, the system is said to be causal. Non-causal system is one if the output of the system has some dependence on the future value, the system is said to be non-causal. Right? So how would you understand causality and non-causal systems? Causal systems must not contain any future input. Right? See, I'm putting it in the other way. Causal system must only contain what? Must only contain present and past values. Causal system must not contain any future input. The moment there is a future input dependence on the output of the system, you will call the system to be non-causal systems. So if there is a future input dependence, then the system becomes non-causal. If there is no future term involved in the output of the system becomes causal. Right? So causal system is one if the output has only present and past values. Non-causal system is one which has some dependence on the future values of the input. That is non-causal system. Okay? So let us try to understand this with certain examples. Says the following systems are causal or non-causal. Look at the first example. Yt is equal to x of t into sine of 1 plus t. Yt is equal to xt into sine of 1 plus t. Right? Where is the input term? Input term is only this. Right? So yt is x of t. Right? So yt is dependent on present value of the input. There is no future term, right? When you are searching for causal and non-causal, search for the future input. This is a smaller hint. Search for the future values. If there is no future value, you will call the system to be causal, right? So how would we justify this? As the output of the system depends on present value of the input and has no dependence, you could see here, and has no dependence on the input values from the future, the system is causal. So there is no future value, immediately you could conclude that the system is causal. Let's look at the second example. Yt is equal to x of t plus 1 plus x of t minus 1. So x of t plus 1 indicates future term. X of t minus 1 indicates past. So we got a future term dependence here. Output yt depends on future value of the input. The moment we see a future term involved, we can immediately conclude that the system is non-causal. So how would we justify this? We would say that as the output of the system depends on past input and has dependence on input values from the future. This is important. It has a dependence on the input value from the future. That is, it depends on future values of the input. Therefore, the system becomes non-causal. Right? The moment you see future term, you would say that the system is non-causal. If there is no future term, the future term is absent, the system becomes causal. This is a simpler hint for you to remember causal and non-causal systems. Right? Look at the next example. Yt is equal to x of t by 4. So to understand this, we will analyze this system for different time instants. So let us take it for t is equal to 4. So when we evaluate it for t is equal to 4, we get y of 4 is equal to x of 1. So when I put t as 4 here, I get x of 1. So with respect to time instant 4, x of 4 would have indicated present input. Any value less than 4 indicates past. Any value greater than 4 indicates future. So here, x of 1, y of 4 is dependent on x of 1. It means that it is a past input. But let us even check for the negative values. This is not the only concluding check, right? Let us even check for some negative instance of time also. So what we see here, when t is equal to minus 4, y of minus 4 is a function of x of minus 1. So what we obtained here, y of minus 4 is x of minus 1, right? So with respect to time instant t minus 4, minus 1 is the future time instant. So therefore, here what we observe is that output is a function of future value of the input, right? The first analysis revealed past input. The second analysis revealed future input. So we clearly understood that here output is a function of future values of the input, and therefore the system becomes non-causal. So if you would have stopped with a single analysis, then the complete system prediction would have gone wrong. So check it for all the possible time instants. Right? So what we understand here is that when t was 4, there is a past input identified. But when t took a value minus 4, there is a future input dependence which is identified. And the moment future input dependence is identified, the system becomes non-causal. So as the output of the system depends on past input and has a dependence on input values from the future, the system is non-causal. So you would say that the system is non-causal. Let look at the next example. Yt is equal to d of x of t by dt. So it's a differentiation. Output is a differentiation of input signal. Yt is differentiation of input signal. So how would you say that this system is static or dynamic? This system is causal or non-causal? How would we predict that this particular system is causal or non-causal? So for t is equal to 0, let us check it for the time instant t is equal to 0. So we get here y of 0 is dx of 0 by dt. If I put t as 1, y1 is dependent on differentiation of x of 1 of dt. Right? So output is simply dependent on present input. So y of 0 is dependent on x of 0, y of 1 is dependent on x of 1. Right, so output is clearly a function of only present input. There is no future term involved. So no future term involved means the system becomes causal. Right, so as the output of the system depends on present input and has no dependence on the future values of input, the system is causal. So this is how you justify that the system is a causal system, right? The same thing applies for DT signals also. So the next example is yn is equal to sine of x of n, right? So yn is a function of x of n. So yn is dependent on only present value of the input. There is no future term involved here, no future input term involved. Right, so output is only a function of present values of the input. So y of 0 is dependent on x of 0, y of 2 is dependent on x of 2. So yn is a function of only present values of the input, and hence the system is causal, as the output of the system depends on present input and has no dependence on the future value, and hence the system is causal. Look at the next example, yn is equal to x of 3n. When such an analysis comes, you know, such a system representation comes, better to analyze it for different time instants. So check the value of the system for n is equal to 2. So when n is equal to 2, y of 2 is x of 6. When I put here n is equal to 2, we get y of 2 to be x of 6, right? Y of 2 is equal to x of 6, right? So y of 2, that is the present output, the time instant is n is equal to 2. So the output at y is equal to 2 is dependent on x of 6, which is nothing but the future input. But if I analyze n is equal to minus 3, at n is equal to minus 3, y of minus 3 is x of minus 9, past input. But we have identified future input dependence. The moment output depends on the future value, right, we could easily conclude that the given system is non-causal. So as the output of the system depends on past input and has dependence on future values from the input, right, so the system is non-causal. Next example, yn is equal to k is equal to 0 to n minus 3 x of k. So how would you say that this system is causal or non-causal? So if such are the examples, better you expand the summation, assuming some time instant, you expand this summation. So we'll choose the time instant n is equal to 0, right? So y of 0, so at the time instant n is equal to 0, y of 0 becomes, wherever there is n in the equation, replace it by 0. So k is equal to 0 to minus 3. Summation becomes k is equal to 0 to minus 3 x of k. So now you expand this summation for these values of the limits. You expand this summation for these limits, and then you identify in the expanded signal whether you see any past value, future terms, so that you can conclude whether the signal is causal or non-causal. So let us expand this, starting with k is equal to 0. So x of 0, then we need to go to minus 3. So x of minus 1, x of minus 2, and x of minus 3. Right? So these are the only terms which we get when we expand this summation. Now you search out the terms, whether they are present or whether they are past values or future terms. So look at the time instant that you have chosen. Your time instant is 0. So x of 0 indicates the present state of the input, because you have chosen n to be 0. So x of 0 indicates the present state of input. So any values less than 0 become the past values, and any values greater than 0 becomes the future terms. So what we see here, there are all the values minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, which are less than 0 time instant. So x of minus 1, x of minus 2, x of minus 3 all indicate the past inputs. They all indicate the past inputs. So output is dependent on present input, past inputs. No future term is involved. Output is not dependent on any future input, and hence you would say that the system is causal, as the output of the system depends on present input, past input, and has no dependence on input values from the future. The system is causal.